Hi everyone, welcome back to the channel. It's been a while since my last video. Today we will be looking at how to leverage the Autodesk Data Exchange extensions for Revit and how to report this data in Microsoft Power BI. Building information modeling, or BIM in short, and data connection and integration has become an essential part of large-scale projects. While a massive amount of information is produced during the lifecycle of a project on the Autodesk Construction Cloud, this data is trapped within this Common Data Environment, or CDE in short. This becomes an obstacle for non-BIM users and stakeholders outside the ACC ecosystem. Using Microsoft Power BI and the Autodesk Data Exchange extensions, interactive visualization and analysis of data from a 3D model in Power BI is possible. This video will demonstrate how to connect Revit data on ACC to Power BI using the Autodesk Data Exchange process. But first, what is an Autodesk Data Exchange? Data exchanges are a cloud-based method of enabling you to share data more easily across the apps and teams you work with every day. A data exchange is created from a 3D view in the model, and through data exchanges, you can work with the subsets of data you need instead of entire design models. Data exchanges are supported by Autodesk Revit, Autodesk Inventor, McNeil Rhino, Microsoft Power Automate, and other third-party products. When speaking of key capabilities, Autodesk data exchanges allow you to share the contents of a 3D view and not an entire file, access only the specific and relevant data. Audit trails are automatically created since it is cloud-based. Autodesk Docs automatically versions up data exchanges when the source Revit file is published or uploaded to the Files tool. Neutral data format, which can be loaded into other applications. Please note that data exchanges are currently only supported in ACC projects located on the US and EU data storage regions. As mentioned, although there are data exchange plugins for a variety of programs, in this video I will be focusing on the data exchange between Revit and Power BI. Let's get started. What do we need? You will need Revit 2023.1 or higher, an ACC project folder with the relevant permissions to store the created data exchange files. Power BI, which, in most cases, can be obtained from the Microsoft Store on Windows, the data connector for Power BI from the Autodesk App Store, and the Revit connector, also from the Autodesk App Store. You can find the relevant links in the video description below. Create data exchanges on ACC. If you have already published 3D views from Revit using the Publish settings under the Collaborate tab, you can use these views to create data exchanges directly on ACC. On ACC, open the Revit file containing the published view, click on Sheets and Views, and select the desired 3D view. Click on the three dots next to the view name and select Create Data Exchange. Choose a location and name and click Create Exchange. If you are creating the data exchanges in Revit, this is how you do it. Step 1. Set up a folder on ACC to store the data exchanges. In an ACC project, create a folder to store the data exchanges. Make sure the permission settings include the relevant stakeholders. Set folder permissions to create, upload, or hire. Step 2. Create a Revit 3D view to be exported as data exchange. In Revit, create a 3D view that contains the desired elements for the data exchange. Use Visibility Graphics Override to hide element categories that are not needed for export. Use View Templates to make this process faster. These view templates can be shared and deployed across Revit projects. If you are using linked models and want to federate them in Power BI, use scope boxes to limit the same area of interest in all linked models. Copy and paste these scope boxes by using Align to Same Place. A data exchange needs to be created for every model that will be federated in Power BI. Step 3. Export Data Exchange to ACC Folder. In the Collaborate tab, click on the Data Exchange button. The Data Exchange dialog allows you to create a new data exchange from the current 3D view or update an existing one. Add a name and select the corresponding folder path in ACC. Click on Create Data Exchange. Now you will be able to look and open the data exchange files in ACC. Data exchanges in ACC. Data exchanges saved to ACC can be viewed using the ACC Model Viewer. The usual Model Viewer tools, for example, sectioning, are also available. Data exchanges can also be used to create issues using the Issues tool in the ACC Model Viewer. Now that we saved our data exchanges to the construction cloud, we will go through the process of importing this into Microsoft Power BI. Step 1. Import data exchange to Power BI. Start a blank Power BI report. Click on Get Data and search for the Autodesk Data Connector. Click Connect. Select data exchange as the source type and, if you want, the units of length. Click OK. Navigate to the ACC project folder where the data exchanges have been saved and select the ones for import. Click Load. Step 2. Federate imported data exchanges. If you are importing various data exchanges that need to be federated, relationships between the data exchanges have to be created using Model View. Click on Manage Relationships. Add new relationships as needed using the column Federated Viewer Mapping. Click Save. Step 3. Install the Model Viewer Visual. Click on Import a Visual from a File and add the Autodesk Connector Visual using the file path shown on screen. Click Open. Step 4. Add imported data to the Model Viewer Visual. Click on the visual to add it to the Power BI Canvas and select it. Start adding data tables to the relevant field wells of the visual using the Data search bar. Search for Viewer, External Element ID, and Category. If you are using federated data exchanges, you need to add the data tables from each imported data exchange to the visual. Step 5, add other visuals to complement the data to be analyzed. Add other visuals to the Power BI report and associate relevant data from the data exchanges to generate an interactive data report. Publish the report to the web to share it with other stakeholders. And that's it. Let me know in the comments if you have any questions about the process. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Until next time.